So any doubt yesterday session or any else doubt that you want to ask, you can ask me right now. Anyone having any question or any doubt, please ask me before proceed further. सर वो एक दिन में नहीं आएगी, इट विल टेक सम टाइम. कीप ऑन प्रैक्टिस एंड ऑटोमेटिकली वन डे यू विल अंडरस्टैंड इट. ओके, दिस प्रॉब्लम कैन बी सॉल्व विद दिस एंड दिस प्रॉब्लम कैन बी सॉल्व विद दैट. ओके, सो एट इट्स गुड दैट यू आर ट्राइंग टू सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम्स, दैट्स अ ग्रेट, एंड यू आर ट्राइंग टू डू द यू आर ट्राइंग टू मेक द लॉजिक्स, दैट्स अगेन द ग्रेट पार्ट. बट यस, इट विल टेक सम टाइम, ऑप्टिमाइजेशन विल टेक सम टाइम. Because the main concern is this one, that you must have knowledge about the logics, how exactly the logics are implemented. First, don't focus on the optimized for this point of time. First, try to solve the problem. And after that, try to solve the optimization. When your problem is sorted by the, you know, with the one solution, then move to the another one. Okay, if you start from the very first stage, you start for the optimization technique. So that would be not, you know, the good way to move further, because you are not an expert level, you are just on a fresher level, and you are doing this programming after so many years, and you are doing very great that you are doing you are attempting by your own. So it's a very good achievement for you at this point of time, because you are coming back to this field after I suppose 20 to 23 years. So it's very fruitful, it's very great that you are doing such kind of things. Even the students who are coming from the technical background, they don't attempt the problem statement as well, but you are trying to do it, that's again the appreciable. Okay, so don't worry, as you proceed further, automatically you will start thinking about the optimization, how exactly the optimizations are there. So I always recommend you guys try to make a generalized code. Okay, don't think about a single point, just try to make a code that should be always the generalized code. When you start making the generalized code, automatically the optimization came into the picture. Okay, so anyone having any another doubt, you can ask me before move further. Okay, so now I'm going to start the next topic. We see if, for, nested for, while, okay, and then we see string, then we see list, then we see, you know, the tuple, okay. We describe these things into the great detail. So now we are moving further. So the two major data types which are left, the one is the dictionary, that is the dict, and second one is the set. So today we will discuss about the dictionary, how exactly the dictionaries are work, and how you can perform the activities on the dictionaries. Okay, so when you talk about dictionary, so dictionary representation is this one that we already discussed into the previous section. Dictionary is representing with the help of these point, okay, these curly braces. So how you can confirm it's a dictionary or not, with the help of the type. When you press type D, automatically you will get the output at the class of dict. So that's mean it's a dictionary object. Okay, so now we will see what are the various methods which are available inside the dictionary, how you can proceed with the dictionary. If I'm talking about the dictionary, that's mean I'm talking about the key and value pairs. Okay, the similar like a class. Inside your class, the roll number is a key, because that is unique for everyone. Okay, unique for everyone. When I call the roll number 101, that's mean I'm calling a person, and person is coming from the different attributes. Let's suppose this Ram, okay, coming from Chandigarh, okay, and the age is, let's suppose, the 25, and so on. So keep this point into the mind. The same exactly you can concern this concept into your dictionary. If I talk about this 101, so what is the meaning of that? That I'm talking about the roll number, and roll number will always be unique. Okay, roll number is always unique inside the class. The same fundamentals over here. If you want to define a key, okay, if you want to define a key, then key is always unique. Keep this point into the mind. And we already know this is the fall under the mutable objects. The meaning of that, if you try to do the overwriting, the previous key will be overwritten. Okay, so keep this point into the mind. The roll number 101 is assigned to the Ram, but if you try to change it, yes, you can change it, that roll number becomes Sham. So this one is the key point to understand the concept of the dictionary. The same, because Ram doesn't have any identity. Okay, inside university there are n number of Rams, but the roll number is unique. Okay, inside class the same, the n number of Rams can be there, but the roll number 101 represents this particular Ram. and this Ram has some another attributes. Okay, so keep this point, keep this terminology when you are performing the dictionary. And one thing is also, you know, that implemented over here, the roll number here inside a class that always be the integer, but in this case the key, so because here I am considering this roll number as a key, so key can be integer, key can be anything, don't worry about it, key can be anything, it doesn't mean that always the key should be integer, so keep this point into the mind. But yes, it is mandatory that key should be unique. If you overwrite it, if you try to define the same key, then it will overwrite the previous value. Your previous values will be losted out because that value doesn't have any identity. Okay, the value same can be there. The value same can be there. Let's suppose I am the person. Okay, I am a person and I bought a product, and that product is the mobile. Okay, let's suppose the Samsung mobile, or you can say the Apple mobile. Okay, another person, let's suppose this is my identity, another person again can buy the same thing. Okay, that's mean the value can be same, but the customer ID is always different. You can check it out over here. Okay, so keep this point into the mind. The value can be same, that doesn't matter, but yes, key should always be unique in the case of the dictionary. So this is very common fundamentals, common terminologies to understand the concept of the dictionary. Now we are moving ahead. What exactly the various methods are available inside the dictionary, how you can proceed with the dictionary. Okay, so for example, if I define D like this, so it will be the dictionary. Why so? Because the priority of the dictionary is higher than this set. So when you print type of D, the output would be dict. Okay, the dictionary is nothing, but for our convenient we speak the dictionary, but the actual class who is responsible, that class is called dict. Okay, so this one is a dict object. D is a dict object. Keep this point into mind. So as we already know, the dictionary is collection of the key value pair. How you can define the value inside this? For example, this one, 101. Okay, the name can be Ram, the same I am taking. 102, the name can be Shyam. Okay, yes, it can be. Okay, 103, again the person name is Ram. Okay, again the person name is Ram. So same, the next. Okay, I am taking this time Ravi. Okay, and 500. So this become a key, this become a value. Yes, it is acceptable. You can take as a this pair as well. Okay, even you can take like this 108:105. Okay, yes, it is acceptable. Okay, 109:102. Yes, it can be acceptable, don't worry about it. So again, this can be also happen, Raj. Okay, Kumar. Yes, this can be happen, don't worry. Okay, so these are the possibilities where you can make the combination. The first combination which I show you, the one is the key is into the integer format and the values are into the form of the string. Again, in the second combination which I show you, which take a key as a string and value as an integer, here the another combination is there, and in this combination you can check it out, the both the values are considered into the integer family. Here the both the values are considered into the integer family. Another, there is one more combination where the both the keys and the values are considered into the string family. So there is no hard and fast rule that the key should always be integer or something like this. No, it is not like that. Even you can define something like this as well. For example, 109. Okay, 9 is already there, it override the previous value. 8 is already there. Let's suppose 112:. Okay, so here I am defining it 10 20 30. Yes, it is acceptable. I already told you the key can be anything, the value can be anything. Yes, it is acceptable. So here the key which represent the in this much amount of values. Okay, for example, 101, the name I define the Ram, age I define the 25, department I define the CSC. Okay, the location I define the Chandigarh. Yes, this can be there, so don't worry about it. This can be anything, can be there. So the collection of the key value pair, but the one is the most important thing is that the key should be unique. If you try to override the previous value, previous key, automatically it will be overwritten, because this is the fall under the concept of the mutable that we already discussed in n number of times. So now I am defining the functionality and what are the various possibilities how you can use this dictionary. I am making a very simple dictionary. Okay, 101 Ram. Okay, and again 102, that is the Shyam. Okay, so now let's suppose this one is my dictionary. I want to process the key. Okay, the slicing concept with the help of the keys. Keep this point into the mind, because this is not a ordered pair. When it is not a ordered pair, that means the slicing is not based on the indexes. Here the slicing that I am performing on the basis of the keys. I will pass this key. Okay, I will pass this key. What I got? I will get this value. That is the RAM. Okay, that is the RAM. Keep this point into the mind. Here the slicing is done, but this slicing is based on the keys, not on the indexes. Earlier that we see the slicing concept, that is based on the indexes, because by default the indexing starting 0, 1 and 2, and you are passing this and automatically you are getting the value regarding the same. Okay, so here this slicing is done on the behalf of the keys, not for the indexes. Keep this point into the mind. Why so? Because it is unordered pair. Unordered pair means the consecutive memory is not there. Okay, so I pass this key, I got this value, that is the RAM. Again I pass this key, I got the value, that is the SHAM. Okay, something like this, I got the entire solution. Okay, so now understand the next one. Let's suppose 500 key is not there and I am trying to fetch out the 500 key. Okay, I'll try to fetch out the 500 key. Now you will get the error message, and that error message is key error. Okay, key error. What is the meaning of that? That I am looking for a 500 key and that 500 key is not available into the dictionary. Definitely you will get this error message, the key error. The key is not available. That's why you are getting the error message. Okay, so how you can tackle this kind of problem? In Python 2, okay, in Python 2, we have a method. Okay, we have a method that method name is has key. Okay, has key. That the method was available inside Python 2, but we are working with Python 3. So this has underscore key. Okay, has underscore key is not available in Python 3. So if you try to perform this method into Python 3, automatically you will get the error message because this is not available. So how you can handle this type of problem? Okay, has key automatically specify, okay, has key, then I have to proceed, otherwise I don't have to proceed. So how you can tackle this problem inside your, you know, the program that you don't want the error, that is the key error. So here, very beautiful, the miscellaneous operator that we already discussed into the third, or I suppose into the fourth section, that is the in. Okay, with the help of in, you are supposed to proceed it. Let's suppose you ask from a user enter key. Okay, this time user enter 500 key. Okay, if, now very simple, if 500 in D. Okay, it will look out. It will look out whether this 500 key is available or not. If it is available, then what I have to print? I have to print D of 500. Otherwise, what you are supposed to print? Print that key is not available. That's it. Key is not available. So this one is the way you can tackle this kind of scenario, because sometime you are supposed to ask the value from the user and user maybe enter anything. If he enters and you directly implement it, then you will get the error message. So how you are supposed to solve this error? With the help of this in operator. Okay, in is very powerful operator, as we see n number of time in every data type, every data structure we use this in. So here again in is applicable. So with the help of in, you can tackle this kind of problem. Okay, so this slicing, I already told you, this slicing is done on the basis of the key. For example, now this time you overwriting the value. Okay, now you overwriting the value, you assign a new value. Now what is happening? Let's suppose I assign a new value, that is the XXX. Now this XX has been updated into this. Okay, updated into this, because this is the concept of the mutability. And the mutability objects are those objects which can be easily, you can say, which can easily changeable. So here I change this key, I reassign. Okay, this is the concept of the assignment. I reassign a new value to 101 key. And what value that I assign this value. That's it, simple funda. Okay, so this is the way to change the existence key, okay, the previous key with new value. So this concept, keep this point into the mind. Okay, we show how we can fetch the data from this dictionary with the help of the keys. If the key is not available, then how you can handle that scenario? You can handle that scenario with the help of the if and in. Okay, and this is the concept of the mutability. So if you try to overwrite something, happily it will be override the existing one. If the key is not there, then it will again give you the error message that key is not available. Later on, we will understand more detail, you know, about this dictionary. So this is very basics to understand the concept of the dictionary, because this is very useful component. N number of time in n number of problem, you are going to use this component. And you can, the problem last time that you asked me is, I don't know who asked me the problem. The problem was, sir, I want to directly assess the values. So this is the way you can directly assess the values. Okay, this one is the way. Last time that I told you the sequential process in the case of the MySQL, that is the sequential process. Okay, when the sequential process is there, let's suppose you want to process this item, you have to iterate through all these items, 998 items. Here you are supposed to iterate it, then you are supposed to process this item. But in this case, you can directly hit on the particular key. Okay, so if I talk about the real-time implementation, the real-time implementation is inside the Facebook. Okay, inside the Facebook, they use the this mechanism, and there that data type is called key value pair. Okay, the key value pair is a data type which is used to hold your username and password. Okay, which is you hold your username and password. The Facebook username password, they don't use MySQL. If I store all the username and passwords into the MySQL, then what will be happen? It will take, you know, the very huge amount of time to process your username and password. But apart from that, they are processing the same thing with the help of these key value pairs. Okay, the conceptual are same. Okay, this one is the concept which is used into these data types as well. Okay, so keep this point into the mind. And very fast, its processing is very fast, and you can sequential process, not a sequential process, you can random process over here. You can directly hitting, you are directly passing this key, and automatically according to that key, you are getting the value. So how they store this data, now understand this concept. If I talk about these keys and value pair, your username become key. Okay, as you know, the username should always be unique, and your password can be similar for everyone. Okay, even I can say I can use the same password, you can use the same password, but the user, for every user, that is the different. So the same scenario over here, but at that time they use the concept of this NoSQL databases, and which mechanism that NoSQL database use for store the username and password inside the Facebook, that is the key value pair. Okay, so that's it. I give you the real time implementation where exactly these kind of things are used. So let's move further. Anyone having any question till now, you can ask me before proceeding further.
I have a question.
Yeah, please ask.
Suppose we want to change, like, is it always be key always come first? Is it like?
Yeah, sir. Yes, sir. Yes. You have to follow the same sequence. The key should always be first. 101. Okay. Value can be this.
Like, there one more question. Like, if we want change the key value, how are we gonna change that?
Sir, I already told you, we change it. If you want to change this value, you can change this value.
When I want the key number, like 101, like you wrote, I want...
No, sir, you are not supposed to change it. You are not supposed to change it. But if that 102 key is not available, you can reassign the new key like this. Okay, like this. This is the way. And then what you can do, you can delete this one. This is the way. Otherwise, there is no direct way that you are supposed to change this key. There is no direct way. Ultimately, this concept is happening. If you want to change it, ultimately, this concept is happening on the behind. Okay?
Yeah. Got it.
Okay, thank you. Anyone having any question before proceed further?
I take that all the other functions, the way we have learned in the list, and you know, kind of append and copy and delete, we will have similar functions.
Yes, definitely. We have function which I didn't show you right now. I just asked, I'll show you each and everything. There are again 10 to 15 methods which are available with this. Don't worry about it. Okay, I will explain.
Second thing, you know, the way you have given example of the real time using the Facebook. Should it right to say, like, you know, the way the India is currently doing, having the Aadhaar card.
Aadhaar card database again also into the NoSQL databases. I suppose that data is on the MongoDB. Again, that is the fall under the category of the documented, you know, the documented type databases. I already told you NoSQL is very powerful. Where your SQLs cannot do, you have to switch out of the box. The types of the NoSQL, column oriented, okay, the column oriented, that is your HBase. Okay, because everything is decided on, not on, you know, on the gut shot feelings. The things are decided on the Bayes theorem. The basic availability and something like this, not a bias, that is the CAP theorem. Okay, on the CAP theorem, everything is decided on the CAP theorem. First, the client come to me, he describe himself what exactly that he want to do. According to the client requirement, then I switch to the technical team, and technical team will be decide each and everything on the basis of this CAP theorem, consistency, availability, and the partition tolerance. Okay, this one is again very big topic. If I start discussion on this NoSQL, our diversion will be moved to somewhere else. So keep this into the point. There is no such something like this. Okay, you are saying your problem, and automatically your development team gonna to start the problem. First, everything is discussed, and that concept is based on this CAP theorem. Okay, the CAP theorem will be decide what exactly the problem statement, whether it's fall on the CA whether it is fall on the AP, whether it is fall on the CP. According to that I am supposed to define the problem. Okay, then I am supposed to define the architecture part, which database I have to use. Just take a simple example. If I take this, the consistency. Okay, the consistency mean, let's suppose you are making a website for the railway reservation system. For inside the railway reservation system, what exactly happened? Let's suppose at 10:02 PM, okay, I book a ticket and you are looking for the same ticket. Okay, let's suppose you want to go from Chandigarh to Delhi and you book a ticket at 10:02 PM, okay, and B1 is allocated to you, and let's suppose the seat number is 222. Okay, just imagine it. At 10:01 PM I am logging and I am hitting on the same scenario, but at that time I will see this one is booked. Okay, this one is booked. So this type of requirement is mine. So how I can solve this requirement? With the help of the consistency. Okay, consistency. So in this concept that you have to go with some another database. The MySQL will not play a good role over there. You have to think about the MongoDB, or you can think about someone else. Let's suppose the HBase, Cassandra. Okay, so I give you just simple example. So my requirement is this one. According to that requirement, you are supposed to design the architecture of the my application or my software, whatever that I want to design. Okay,
yes.
So there are n number of things. It doesn't mean that only one thing is there. There are n number of things. Yeah, please ask.
Is it right to think that in that, the thing which we were learning yesterday, like the bubble chart, or short where we jump to the half. So going back to the Aadhaar card, so if somebody is database trying to search particular Aadhaar card,
sir, understand this concept, that problems, that if you talk about the Aadhaar card, then I suppose there are more than 100 crores of records. Okay, because our population is more than that. So at that time these kind of techniques are not happens. Okay, so your MySQL kind of things will not play the important role. Okay, so at that time the algorithm that is used, that is the random tailor. Okay, random tailor is the algorithm which is responsible to do the such kind of things. So because again the data is aggregated, doesn't mean that every data is on a single server. Data is aggregated, and this random, okay, this concept is basically based on the YouTube streaming. What exactly happens inside the when we do the YouTube streaming? So let's suppose you are watching a movie. Okay, you are watching a movie. Eventually your network breakdown. Okay, your network breakdown. Now what will happen? What you will do? You will start hitting. Okay, at some time you get the same point where exactly your network is breaked. You understand this concept? Now understand my point. You understand this concept? Okay, this one is the point where my network is breaked. Again, after few seconds, again the same thing is happened. So this time in the first attempt, you took, I suppose, 3 or 4 times. Okay, four hits basically to get the exact location. But if the same thing happened after 1 second or after 2 seconds, immediately you will get the same location within 1 or 2 hits. I think the picture is clear. So these kind of things are taken care by this kind of algorithm, that is the random tailor. And with the NoSQL database, this algorithm is used n number of times. If I talk about this MongoDB, that is again fall under the NoSQL database, and in this database this random tailor kind of things are implemented. Okay, so I give you just simple scenario.
You have, and this is very childish question, I know, but I'm sure no question is a stupid question. So you have given so many names in last 2 minutes. And now how we will know which one is the best one?
So you sir, every in my every batch this question is always come. You don't need to remember each and everything, sir. If you try to remember each and everything, what will happen? You will divert it. Okay, so don't worry about it, because you are into the learning age and I am into the way. If I will keep update myself, then I will survive long, because student can ask n number of question as you ask me something. So I must have answer of that question. How I can get the answer? If I studied well, okay, if I read the blogs, if I do the practical part, then I supposed to give the answer of your question, because every question I don't have the answer. So don't worry about it, don't get confused for this kind of thing, sir. What should we have to keep remember, and what we should learn, these kind of things. I am working with these things last 5 to 6 years. Okay, prior to that even I don't know anything. Before 2015, I started my career in 2015 with the big data and Hadoop. I take more than hundreds of batches for this big data and Hadoop, and I train more than 500 or 600 students for this big data Hadoop. At that time, I learn a lot, and my journey started in 2015 with the help of the big data and Hadoop. I was the only person who was teaching big data Hadoop into the Chandigarh. I started this batch first time in Chandigarh. Okay, so at that time I learned so many things for big data. That is my favorite topic. I learned so many things, and eventually and slowly I moved to the Python, then I moved to the the machine learning, okay, then I moved to the statistics as well, then I moved to the the Azure part as well. So slowly each and everything that you will learn, but don't try to learn everything into the one shot. So it will be very difficult if I say you, okay, this is the NoSQL. But yes, now you guys are get the little introduction about the NoSQL. Okay, NoSQL is something. So, but if you try to learn this NoSQL, you will get confused. Okay, because I don't know the each and everything. I know I have good command over HBase. Again, it is very complicated. I have good command over HBase. That is the Hadoop NoSQL database. Because when I was teaching Hadoop, there was a part of the HBase, and it took me to understand this HBase even 5 to 6 days, what exactly the architecture for this. I even didn't understand in one shot what exactly that HBase and how exactly it work. After slowly it took me 5 to 6 days into the HBase. Now I am comfortable with HBase. I can make the n number of the use cases into this HBase. So don't feel it, you are supposed to learn each and everything. You cannot learn each and everything, but yes, slowly, if you keep on updating yourself, doesn't mean that you just learn Python and after then stop. No, again, you will stuck over there. But yes, if you keep on learning, keep on learning, and one day you will automatically understand it. And try to learn, try to read out the blocks, okay, because this is the only one way to learn the technology. So don't get confused, because this is my responsibility. Being a trainer, I have to elaborate each and everything, but knowledge that I have. It doesn't mean that I am a perfect. No, it doesn't mean that. And it can never be. Okay? Because I am not Google, sir. So any another question that you want to ask? Because this thing is always happen into my, the all of the batches. Yesterday, even Vikas sir and Ajay sir asked me the same question. Sir, you are talking about n number of things and we are getting confused what to learn and what should we left. So I always give the answer, don't try to learn each and everything. Okay, that is not possible. Because for my profession, yes, I have to survive long. Because my profession is something else. I have to keep update myself. Now I am moving for another thing. I did this cloud computing, because I know in future the demand for this one, the student are coming for this one. And I know what happened after that. What happened after that, I know is and everything. So for that point of time, I'm moving into that direction. Okay, because that is my profession. So don't worry, don't get confused to yourself what to learn, what should not learn. So don't worry about it. Just focus on Python first. That's it. Nothing else. I will never suggest you go for Python. Okay, and if I am starting, this cloud computing, I never force you. Okay, guys, now you move to the cloud computing and cloud computing is very best. No, I will never, say you, okay, leave this and move to this, because I don't need money in that context. But I know if you touch with me, automatically will say, okay, sir, teach me the next concept. Automatically you guys will say. So don't worry about it. So come back to the main topic, that what we are discussing. That we are discussing about the dictionary, that the dictionary highly used again. Now I am making a very small program with the help of the dictionary. Student name and percentage. I am making a very small program, and I will give you the assignment into the same program. Okay, now first understand the basic concept. Let me do the practical first, then the picture would be more clear for you. Now you can see this one is a hive. Okay. This one is a hive. Now you will say, sir, okay, now hive is one more term. Now this, all the practicals are belong to the hive, which I didn't disclose into this session, into this discussion. These are all the practical that are these are the all the practical which are associated with the hive. You can check it out. earlier when I was teaching the big data and Hadoop, at that time this one is again component for the, you know, the Hadoop. Okay, this Hive, again you can check, I never disclose this MapReduce as well. These are the MapReduce programming methodology and these are the case studies with the help of the MapReduce. Again, this all is done with the help of the Java. Okay, somewhere you can see out the pig. Yes, these are the case study which are used with the help of pig. Now pig, by the way, pig is outdated from the market. Okay, and this one is a Flume. If I didn't disclose till now what exactly the Flume is there. Okay, this one is the HBase. You can check it out. What I told you, this one is the HBase. This is the presentation for the HBase. Okay, so there are a number of things. So don't worry about it. Just keep focus on the Python. That's it. Nothing to do. Now there is one more, that is the Spark. And this Spark can be implemented with the Java or with the Scala or with the R programming language or with the Python as well. So these are the programs that are implemented with the Java. Okay, these are the programs that are implemented with the help of, you know, the with the help of the Scala programming language. These are the all. And what is the Scala? Again, that is the programming language which is used similar like to the Python. But yes, there is a lot of difference between Scala and Python. Okay, so there are a number of things, you don't worry about it. So we are moving to our, this one is the C, C++. Okay, and where is our work? Python for basics. Move to my work. Okay, and then move to Island Bash. Okay, so I'm showing you one small program with the help of these dictionary. Okay, so first I am making a dictionary. The dictionary name is called record. Okay, the dictionary name is called record. Now I am asking from a user how many record that you want to enter. Okay, how many records that you want to enter. Input of enter record. Okay, so now again I am making a one counter. I is equal to this one. I am taking the help of this while loop. These are the previous fundamental that we did n number of time. This one is the loop will be execute for number of time, whatever time that you decide, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so it will ask from the user how many records that you want to enter. Basically on the behalf of that value this loop will be execute. Okay, so first thing that I'm asking, that is the input enter name. Okay, and the second one is I'm asking marks. Okay, int of, you can say input of enter marks. Okay, so second thing that I'm asking the marks from the user, first I ask the name and the second I ask the marks. Now you are supposed to enter all these things into this record dictionary. Okay, so how we can enter this data into the into this dictionary? Now understand the concept. So record, okay, record, and this name will become a key. Okay, name will become a key and the marks will become an output. That marks will become an output. Okay, so again I plus equals to 1 as we know it, because we have to iterate through I. Okay, now after completion of the entire thing, now what I am doing, I am printing the data on the screen. Okay, now you can understand it. This is one line logic only, that's it. What is happening over here? The user enter name, let's suppose the Ravi is enter, and marks that has entered, that is the 50. Okay, now this is appended, the similar like to this. Okay, let's suppose D of Ravi and the marks is equal to 50. Now this has been appended into the record dictionary, because here the dictionary name is record and I use this D, so you can use this REC. Okay, so now this Ravi become the key into here and this value become the value that is associated with this Ravi key. So everything is done. How many times this would be happen? This would be happens, you know, the number of time, how many value that a user will assign. Let's suppose the user assign 5, so it will ask 5 times the name and the marks, and automatically we are appending it. We are appending it similar like to this. If I show you the step by step uses, then you will understand it. Okay, so now let's suppose this one is my dictionary. Inside dictionary I am adding it Ravi. Okay, and the marks that I enter first time, that is the 50. Okay, now again Ravi and then Sham. Okay, this time I mark enter the marks, that is the 70. Okay, now if I print D, now you can check it out. The first will become this Ravi, the Ravi become key, and associated marks become marks. In the second iteration, you enter the name Sham and that become a key, and the marks, that is 70. Same thing, how many times you will execute it, the same thing will be happen n number of times. For example, one more time if I did it, okay, I did it. Now you can check it out. If I overwrite it, let's suppose the Sham, again I overwrite it. Now you can check it out. The previous value has been overwrite. Earlier the value of the Sham was 70, but after executing this statement, the value has been become this. Okay, and this value has been updated in the context of this key. So I think now the picture is very clear about these keys and value pair. Same thing I did over here. But here this time I am taking two variables, name and the marks, and whatever value that your user are entering, and the same thing happening how many times, this depend upon this n value. If this n value, let's suppose the 10, so this would be happen 10 times. If this n value become 2, so it would be happen 42 times. Why I didn't use here roll number? Because I am leaving that part on for your assignment. Okay, because I show you the entire concept with the help of the name. Now I will tell you after execution of this program what changes that you are supposed to made over here. Okay, so first, now the data is entered into the records. Now I want to display that data on the screen. So how I can display? Very simple. Let me implement it over here. For i in d, okay, very simple. If I simply print i, now what you are getting? Now observe this scenario. You are getting only keys. Okay, you are getting only key. How you can fetch the data? How you can fetch the values? With the help of the slicing concept. And how this slicing is implemented? The slicing is implementing with the help of this statement, d of i. That's it. Now you can check it out. The key and the value. Now same thing I am going to implement it over here, because my data is inside the record, for I in record. And what you are supposed to do? Print of the name. Okay, now how I can fetch the name? Simply because inside key, the key is treated as a name. So simply you are supposed to print over here. The I. And how you can find out the value that is associated with that key? With the help of the slicing concept. So for the same marks. Okay, for the same marks. So here, record of I, that's it. Now you can check it out, the output. First, the same thing, save as dict test.py. Okay, the dictionary test.py. So cmd py space. Yeah. One second, let me execute it, then I will come back to you. Okay, so now how many records that you want? It will ask me. Very slow, my system is very slow. Okay, so how many records? I need only 3 records. Okay, so first name is Nitin. Okay, the marks are 78. The second name is Ravi. The marks are, let's suppose, the 75. The third name is Raj. Okay, the marks are... Okay, sorry, I did a mistake. Sorry for this. So two here, HH and marks 33, okay, NN and marks 66, that's it. Now you can check it out. The name is HH, the marks is 33. The name is NN and the marks is 66. Now you ask the question. Okay, ask me the question, what do you want to ask?
Oh yeah, I was just talking to myself here, sorry. I'm saying, like, you know, currently there is only marks attached with the name. If suppose there is a, let's say, A's is attached.
Yeah, definitely, sir. I'm coming back to you guys for the same, because that is your assignment, sir. Okay, that's your assignment. I already told you. I will show you the basic part, and now I'm gonna to give the assignment. So assignment is I need this. Okay, so this one. So this is my record dictionary where I need the data something like this. Okay, so this one is your assignment. You are supposed to ask from the user. Okay, now I think this one is your question. This one is your question, I suppose. Yeah, yeah.
So
But
I was saying when we said d of i, so d of i will display all the three values like RAM, CSE, and 25.
Sir, it's up to it's up to you that you are supposed to display the entire thing on which behalf. That's again the concept of the list. You know the list because this data is came into the form of the list. Whatever the format that you want to describe, you can describe. That is again your logic part. So here the everything can be done. The roll number is 101, the name is Ravi, the department is CSC, and the age is 25. Yes, again the second one, the name is roll number is 102. Even what you can do, so this one your assignment, even what you can do, you can generate these roll numbers automatically. If I say okay, the five users, so that's mean from 101 to 105 it will be happen. Okay, every time it will generate a dictionary. Okay, how many times that you will execute that program, on that number of time it will generate the roll number in the sequence of 101, 102, 103, 104, and 105, and that should automatically generate it. Okay, that should automatically generate. You are not supposed to generate by your own, because let's suppose you are making a university software. At that time you are not supposed to generate the the roll number by your own. Automatically your software will suggest to you, okay, the next should be this one, the next should be this one, the next should be this one. But for this point of time, you don't know the database, because at that time the data is coming, last value is coming from the database. But this point of time, you don't know about the databases. Okay, later on you can do the same thing. When we do the file handling, what you can do, you can store all the data into the files, and after processing the data, after let's suppose you want to add the new record or you want to append the new record, it will automatically pick out the last value from your file and assign the roll number according to that value. Now you think the picture is clear to you guys? Okay, for this point of time, don't worry about that concept, but yes, you are supposed to generate these roll numbers automatically. But in the real time scenario, how exactly happened? The data is coming from the some third party software, for example the database, okay, for example the MySQL, for example the data can be come from the files and as well, okay, data can be coming from the n number of softwares. So this point of time, because we don't know the file handling, you are supposed to take the data and you are supposed to represent the data into this sequence. Okay, so don't bother about that concept. Later on when we will understand the file handling concept, then we will do the same thing. I don't know what happened to him. Let me restart it. Okay, in the meanwhile, if anyone having any question, please let me know. Now I think everyone understand the assignment, what exactly supposed to do. Okay, so let me once more try for say. Okay, so now we are moving further. This one is your first assignment that you are supposed to do. Now we know how you can update the dictionaries. No, I think this is not working now. Okay, so this one is my dictionary. So now I am showing you all the things are practically. So let's suppose you want to delete a key. The question that was, sir, I want to delete this key. So del of d of, let's suppose I want to remove this Ravi. Okay, simply that you are supposed to pass this Ravi, that's it. Okay, now you can check it out, the Ravi has been deleted with the help of del of, okay, with the help of del of Ravi. Now the key, the Ravi has been deleted. Hanji, please.
Recording, I think something wrong with recording.
No. Yes, I don't know what happened to my system. No, it's working, I suppose. It's working. Recording is working. Okay, recording is working. So now the next is del of Ravi. So that's mean you deleted this Ravi, and this is one way. Okay, d dot clear, the same, exactly same, d dot clear. Now the dictionary has been clear, all the previous content has been removed from the dictionary with the help of clear. The same, exactly same in the case of the list. In the case of the list, exactly when we perform the clear, automatically the content has been removed. Same thing implemented over here. Okay, so let's suppose you want to remove the existence of this dictionary. Okay, I don't want to the continue with dictionary anymore. So here the concept is called del of d. Now the memory existence has been removed. So when now after executing this del of d, when I perform d, automatically you will get the error message d is not defined. Why so? Because I remove the existence of this dictionary. So del, okay, del, if you want to remove the specific key, okay, if you want to remove the entire dictionary at that time, here I pass the key, which key that I want to remove, but at this point of time I just simply write d. Okay, so d dot clear mean if you want to clean this dictionary, you want to remove the existing data from this dictionary. Okay, so these are very basic things that you must have idea about all these things. Now moving ahead, now I am generating one more key. I am generating one more key, and the key which contain 102 colon, okay, 102 colon, let's suppose xx. 103 contains the value that is the yy, okay, and there is one more, 104, okay, which contains 123, okay. So this one is my new dictionary. So I want to find it out the len, okay. The len is a function, as we know very well, the same thing implemented over here. So it gives you the number of keys. As you can see that there are three number of keys. Now keep this point into the mind. If the value is there, the key is there. If the key is there, then the value is there. It cannot be like that, the key is only key is there, only value is there. No, it is not possible. That would be the wrong syntax. Okay, so if the key is there, that's mean the value is also there. If the value is there, that's mean that that value is associated with some key. So keep this point into the mind. And len mean it returning me the number of key value pairs. So here the number of key value pairs are three. So three key value pairs are coming on the screen. Okay, the three. So this is the way with the help of this len. Okay, the next is get. So get automatically specify. Okay, get automatically specify. Okay, yes, I want to get something. So earlier I show you, if I do this, okay, if I do this d of 500, now you are getting the error message. Okay, how you can handle this situation? If 500 in d, okay, if the 500 in d, then print of d of 500, otherwise you are supposed to print, okay, this is the syntax mistake, sorry for that, otherwise you are supposed to print that is not available. Okay, not available, that's it. Okay, so I am showing you, now the output would be not. Why so? Because this 500 key is not available. So this one is the one way to handle this scenario. Another way, same thing can be handled with one line of code with the help of get. Okay, now observe this scenario, d dot get. Okay, what I want to get? I want to get 500. That 500 key is not there, so it is returning me none. Okay, the meaning of that is it is not giving me the error, it's giving me none. Okay, it's giving me none. If I print this, now you can check out, it is returning me none. That's mean that is not available. But I don't want this none. Okay, I don't want this none. I want my own specific value. So how you can get your own specific value? Simply with comma. Okay, simply with comma and not present. Okay, like this. So if the key is not there, then it will give you not present. Okay, let's suppose the key is there, my key that is available, that let's suppose I'm looking for 102, and 102 is available inside this dictionary, and I implemented with the help of this get. Now in the case of 500, because there is no this key available inside this dictionary, at that time it's return me not present. But this time 102 key is available, and I perform the same thing with the help of get. Now what output I will get? I will get output that is the xx. Okay, so let me show you. So now I think the picture is clear to you guys. If the key is there, then it will return you the associated value. If the key is not there, then it will return you whatever that you want to return. If you leave it empty, at that time it will return you none. Choice is again your, what the way you feel comfortable, you can proceed with that. If you feel this is the comfortable way, then go with this. If you feel this is the comfortable, then go with this. Okay, so the next is the pop. So pop is again a method, d dot pop. Okay, what you want to pop? I want to pop 102, that's it. Now it removed this 102 from the data. Now you can check it out, it removed the 102 from the data. There is one way to remove with the help of del, There is another way with remove with the help of this pop. Now, what is the difference between dash 2? When you use the pop, it will return you the value whatever the key that you removed. Okay, understand my point. Whatever value it removed 102. Okay, and 102 the value is xx. When I perform this, it return me xx. Okay, it return me the associated value. But in the case of del of, now you can check, del of d of 103. Now it doesn't return me anything. So sometime my choice is this one, okay, which key I removed, I want to check it out, what was the associated value with that. Sometime my requirement is this one, at that time I will take the help of this pop. Okay, at that time I will take the help of this pop. If I don't bother about the value, whatever the key I deleted, I don't bother about the value, at that time you can proceed with that. Choice is again your, on which way you want to proceed, you can proceed. Okay, I show you the difference between del of d key and the pop of d. Okay, so let me try one more. Let's suppose that the key is not there and I'm trying to pop it. Now what is saying? It is giving me the error. Okay, 105, that key is not available. That's mean the key error. Same if I perform over here, again it will give me the key error, that is the 105. So there is no mechanism. If you want to perform that scenario, again you can take this get, you can take the help of this get. If you're not comfortable with get, you can go with the if condition that we already discussed, this one. Okay, so the next is the pop item. Okay, d dot pop item. So pop item, arbitrary key value pair, it remove the, you know, the any key value pair from this entire data, just like a pop that we implemented in the case of the list. The pop will remove the last one, but in it is unordered pair, so that's why it will remove the any arbitrary element. Okay, so this time the dictionary is empty and I'm trying to implement the pop item. So keep this point into the mind. The pop and pop item, the pop is used to remove the specific item, and whenever I use the pop, okay, it return me the associated value, which is the return which is associated with this key, and I removed from the entire dictionary. When I use this pop item, the pop item is basically used, it's mean it will remove the any arbitrary pair. Okay, any, let's suppose this one, let's suppose this one, let's suppose this one. Okay, so it depends upon the situation or the scenario. Automatically that is controlled by the Python interpreter itself. Okay, so the next is, let's suppose our dictionary is empty now. Okay, let me enter some data into this. 1:102, 2:203, okay, 4:404. Okay, so this one is my data inside my dictionary. Now the data is this one. So I want to only fetch the keys. Okay, I want to only fetch the keys. So how I can fetch d dot keys? Okay, with the help of these keys. Now you can check it out. You are getting all the keys that you get. Okay, you want to iterate them. So how I can iterate them? For I in d dot keys. Okay, so I in d dot keys, print of I, that's it. Now you will get all the keys with the help of these keys. Same thing, if you don't want to implement keys, don't worry about it. You can simply execute like this. Okay, there is, both are same. Okay, okay. So the next method is, which is associated, that method is called values. Okay, values. So values, it will display all the values, 102 102 203 and 404. So these are the values which are associated with the keys. So now you are getting only values with the help of these values. Again there is one more method that is called items. Okay, that is called items. Okay, now item return you key and value both. Okay, key and value both. So if you want to entire the complete pair, okay, so key and value. Now you can check, with the help of items, you are getting all the things, key as well as values. So three methods are there to iterate the dictionary. The one is key, okay, the one is key, another is values, and another is items. So choice is again your, what you want to do. If you want to iterate only values, then go with values. If you want to iterate only keys, then go with keys. If you want to iterate both the keys and values, then you can take the key value pair. Okay, so choice is again, it is up to you and according to the requirement what exactly that you want to do. Okay, the next one is your set default. Okay, set default. So here this one is my dictionary, d dot set default. Now what is the meaning of this? Okay, what is the meaning of this? Now observe carefully. Here is key 1, 2, 4. Okay, 1, 2, 4. Now 5 is a key. Okay, 5 is a key, and I am adding some data. Okay, I am making some string. So this one is my string. Okay, if you are a bit confused with this, okay, I am taking this XXX. Okay, so let's mean I am making a key value pair d dot set default. 5 key will become there and this value become there. Okay, so when I execute it, now you can check it out. One new key value pair is inserted with the help of this default key. Okay, so again understand my point. Let's suppose there is key which is already available. Okay, let's suppose the 2 is already available. Observe carefully. And I press this. Now what I am getting? I'm getting the associated value with this key. Observe carefully this scenario. Let's suppose I don't know is there value or not inside my dictionary. Okay, my choice is this one. If the value is not there, okay, sorry, is the key is not there, if the key is not there inside my dictionary, existing dictionary, okay, I am trying for looking for, let's suppose this 500 key, and this 500 key is not there. If it is not there, then make it key and assign this value. Okay, make it key and assign this value. Now set default method will do, it will assign this key value pair into the existing dictionary. Okay, case number 2, if the value is there, okay, let's suppose dictionary is there and there is a key that is the 101. If the key is there and I'm saying, okay, 101 XXX. Okay, now this time what is happening? This time it will not make this as a key value pair because already 101 key is available. So it will return us the associated value to 101 key. I think this is a bit too confused, but understand this point. Set default mean if the key value is already there, okay, sometime you are asking from a user, okay, 500 key, but that key is not available, but I don't want to generate the error. I want, if the key is not there, automatically this key value pair will be become, okay, after getting the value from the user. But if the key is there, my requirement is something like this. If the key is there, then what I am supposed to do, I want to fetch out the value that is associated to this key. Observe my scenario carefully. At this time of requirement, what you are supposed to do, you take the help of the set default method. Okay, set default is a method, name specify itself. If this is not there, then make it as a default key value pair. If this is there, then you have to return me the associated value to that key. Okay, so sometime our requirement is something like this. So fulfill our requirement. So there is a method, and that method is called set default. Okay, sometime, yes, it can be useful, very useful. Okay, get method is very useful. Okay, your item methods, again, it's very useful. Yes, sometime value method is also useful. Okay, so there is one more method, and that, let's suppose there is one more key, 1:21. Okay, let's suppose I'm making some different values so the picture would be more clear. Ravi: HHH. Okay, something like this. There is one dictionary D, there is another dictionary X. Now I want to extend this dictionary with this. Okay, I want to extend this dictionary with this, or you can say the update, D dot update. Okay, update is a method. Now your D has been updated. D has been updated with this key value pair. So with the help of the update method, you can update the existing dictionary. Okay, so this one is the update method. So I suppose these are all the associated method which are used with the dictionary. And also there is a dictionary comprehension also available. So let's suppose you want to make a dictionary comprehension. Very simple, I: I into I, the format is same. Okay, the format is same, I into I, for I in range of 10. Okay, so you can check. Now you can check the dictionary objects has been created. 0, because I value starting 0, 0 into 0, 0. Now you can check the same key, same value. Okay, again the I value become 1, I into I, that again become 1, key one value. 2, now 2 into 2, 4, it become the key value pair. 3 into 3, 9, it become the key value pair. 4 into 4, 16, 5 into 5, 25, and so on. So this concept is again called the dictionary comprehension. Okay. So I'm making one small program once again. Very simple. Okay, very simple. Write a program to find the number of occurrence of each letter present in a given string. Okay, present in a given string. So this one is my string. So I'm making my string like this. A, B, 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 okay. And I want to check it out. Okay, my problem statement is that, very important problem statement. I want to check it out, how many time A is there, how many time B is there. Okay, that I want to count it out. So how I can tackle this problem? So making an empty dictionary. Okay, for I in X. Okay, I in X. Now observe this scenario. D of X, okay, D of X equals to, okay, D of, not D of X, D of I equals to D dot get, okay, D dot get X comma 0, this is the one way, okay, X comma 0 plus 1, okay, this one is the way, so get method I used it. Get method, I used it. So inside X, iterating through one by one, if dot get, okay, dot get of X, not for X, sorry, here I have to use this I as well, okay, dot of I. Let me explain, then the picture would be more clear to you guys. Okay, so that's it. I think it will work fine. I think it will work fine. Yes, it worked fine. Now observe this scenario, what I did. Very simple use case which I made. So here D of I, okay, D of I mean the starting D of I. What is the I value? B. Okay, D of I equal to B. Now D dot get, okay, D dot get. What is the I? What is the I? The B comma 0 plus 1. Now what I am saying? I am assigning this value in the first case. In the first case, B is there, get of B. Yes, the B is there. Okay, the B is there. Now I am making a dictionary, and this dictionary, the key initially I settle down the key, that is the B. Okay, B, and get of B comma 0. The first case I didn't get anything because the B is not there inside this dictionary. Understand this point with the help of this get method. Because if it is not there, then it will returning me none. But I don't want none. I want my own value. I return 0. And what I did? It is returning me 0 and I am adding plus 1. So what it become? 1. Okay, now this has been allocated in the first case. Now in the second case, the A is there. Okay, again the same scenario would be happen for A. Now A and B become two keys. Again the B is the B occurrence. Now this time, what output I am getting? Understand it. This time I'm not getting 0 because with the help of the get method, if the key is there, then you will get the associated value. If the key is not there, then I'm assigning my own value. But this time B key is already available, then it will return you this one plus 1. Now it again overrated the value to 2. Okay, same thing when A come, again this time the value is 1. So this one plus again this one, now this value is allocated to 2. And so on, it keep on working. At the end of the entire scenario, B become 28, A become 25. Okay, this is the only one line of code. With the help of this one line of code, you are able to implement the concept. Okay, how many A's are there, how many B's are there. I think the picture is clear for this one. Very simple, with the help of the get method. And get method, if you know the usage of the get method, then it become very easy. Otherwise, you are supposed to take some another way. Okay. So anything else that you want to ask from me? Okay, so same scenario I'm using. Now I'm checking it out. Program to find the, you know, the number of occurrence of each vowel present in the given string. Okay, present in the given string. So I'm making a program for the same. Entirely the code would be used this one. So this time again, I am making a dictionary empty. Okay, dictionary empty. So here, one thing I am making a vowel list, okay, the vowel list is this one, because vowels are 5, A, E, IOU. Okay, AEIOU. So that's it. Okay, so this one, now what we have to do, we have to find out the occurrence of vowels. So here vowel is only one, that is the A, and I think this one is a small, so it will not work, I suppose, for the same. Okay, so working the same, so let me try for this. Okay, so if IN, okay, IN, this V, okay, this V, that's it, then you are supposed to perform it, then you are supposed to perform it, I suppose it will work fine. But this time there is no vowel, so it's returning me zero, because I implemented the concept of this, okay, small. So how I can handle this scenario? Dot, okay, so one way that you can try over here, the upper, okay, this is the one way that change the content. No, again it's not working because it's a immutable object, immutable object. Okay, I implemented over here, but the actual, the real is, again, that is the string, you are not supposed to change it. Okay, so keep this point into the mind, the real, you are not supposed to change it. So what I am making, a new string, and here I am making a b a b a b a b. I think it should work fine for the same, and the D is my empty, and inside V we know that are the vowels. If this condition is true, then inside D it becomes this. Okay, A is 17 times, that is occur, only vowel is A. Okay, if you add some more vowels, then the picture would be little different. Okay, so this time I am entering U, and I am entering E, 3 times or 4 times I entered E. Now let's check its code is working fine or not. So here first empty the dictionary, because otherwise it will append after 17. So now you can check the code is working fine. So how many times the vowel is occurrence, because these type of questions are asked n number of time into the fresher level interviews. Okay, so that's it about the dictionary. We saw dictionary comprehension and the associated method which are used with this dictionary. Now your assignments are, the first assignment is same, you are supposed to take the row number and the entire information in the form of the list. This become the value, this become the key. Okay, this one your first assignment, and the second assignment, the previous one, the username and password. Okay, the username and password you are supposed to perform with the help of this dictionary. Okay, with the help of this dictionary. And one program is also there, encryption and decryption. Okay, encryption and decryption. For example, so let's suppose you decide a dictionary like this. For A value, you use this @ sign. Okay, for this B value, you use, let's suppose, this # sign. For C value, you have to define a dictionary like this. Okay, %, and so on. So you decide a dictionary. Now the user enters, for example, user enter CBA. Okay, so after encrypting it, what output you will get? You will get and, okay, then hash, then A. Similarly, you are supposed to perform the unique symbols for entire A to Z. Okay, and this is very the basic level of this encryption and decryption, but there in the real time scenario they use the MD5 algorithm. Okay, or you can say another encryption algorithm as well. But for the learning purpose, that we are making a very simple code for the encryption and decryption of the data. So here, as similar, you are supposed to define a dictionary, and that dictionary contain A to Z, and with relevant to every key, you are supposed to define a special symbol. Okay, for example, I took only these three, A, B, and C. A @, B # and C %, and user enter, let's suppose, CBA. So after encryption data, the output would be similar to like this. Okay, after that, you have to ask from the user, do you want to decrypt it? User say yes, I want to decrypt it. After decrypting of this data, you are supposed to print the data into the same manner. Now understand this usage of this program. You generate this code onto your machine. Okay, and the same code is implemented on the client machine. So you send an email, okay? You send an email to this person. Prior to send an email, you converted the data into entire into this format, okay, with the help of your own you can say the own algorithm. And after converting this data, you send the email, you send to email to the client machine, and client have the same code. He pass this entire data into his or her own application or code and getting the exact information that want to send. Okay, so I think the picture is clear for everyone what you are supposed to do. There are only three assignments for the same, and in the meanwhile, if I come to know any another assignment, then I will discuss that assignment also. I will share the that assignment into the group. Okay, so anyone having any question till now, you can ask me. So I think assignments are clear to everyone. One program which we see earlier, and you are supposed to perform it into the multiple options. And the second one is the same program, the username and password, but this time you are supposed to take the help of the dictionary. And when you are supposed to take the help of the dictionary, at that time the multiple user and the multiple password can be generated. Okay, number of user can use your application who are registered with you, something like this. You can say just make a pair of three, or you can make the pair of four. Rest of the entire code is same. For that point of time, you are supposed to take the help of this dictionary. And this one, the last program, that is the encryption and decryption of the data. You are supposed to make your own algorithm. First, you are supposed to define your own dictionary, okay, and encrypt it. And after the same data, after encryption of the data, you are supposed to decrypt it. Okay, so in the meanwhile, if any another problem come inside my mind, I will definitely share to you guys. So anyone having any question till now before closing this session, please ask me. Anyone having any question, any doubt? Okay, so tomorrow is, I suppose, Saturday. I will confirm whether the class is there or not. Okay, so in the meanwhile, you are supposed to perform all the previous assignment. If the class is not there, you are supposed to deal with the list, you know, the dictionary, and all other whatever we discussed till now, because the next concept is a set. Set is very small topic, hardly it will take half an hour to complete the set. And after completion of set, your basic fundamentals are you know, the cover. And after that, we will move to the next scenario, that is the file handling. After doing the file handling, we will move to the function, okay, and function, then we will move to the further topics, okay, the modules and so on. So I request you guys, please do practice a lot, because these the data types which are highly used when we do the real-time assignments. Okay, when we deal with the file handling, the entire things are same. Okay, the entire things are same, but just what you have to do, you have to implement all these things in the context of the file. At that time, the data is coming from the file. Okay, you are supposed to write the data into the file, or might be data can become from the database, you know, the database storage devices such as a MySQL, Oracle, or even the data can come from the cloud. But the rest of things are same, the same fundamentals are same, that you are supposed to implement the dictionary, or sometime you are implement the list, tuple, okay, all the things are same, for loop, if condition, while. Yes, these are the common things that you are supposed to use. But yes, I once again to recommend you guys, kindly try to solve all the assignment by your own with whatever assignment we did till now. Okay, don't take the help of any Google for this point of time, because you already did n number of assignments. Do by your own, until unless you don't get stuck anywhere, then you are supposed to move to the videos, and then you are supposed to take the reference. Please design the all the problems by your own, then you will learn the programming. Otherwise, you, I'm sorry to say, but this is the harsh and hard words. You cannot learn the programming until unless you are not supposed to design the program by your own. Okay, so any question till now before closing this session, you can ask me.
Sir, the only thing is 30th of July, I have a big meeting that day, so I won't be able to join.
No problem, sir. The recording will be available on the Thursday. I suppose the 30th of July is Thursday. Don't worry, you will get the recording for you all.